Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to another video. Yes, I'm wearing the same shirt because I'm doing three resin unboxings in a row. In today's video, we're taking a look at the last kit that I ended up receiving today from a GK model. And this is going to be from the Monster Hunter series. This is another PVC recap. This is the Mitsun series female gunner. This one really, really piqued my interest. In fact, I didn't even see it on there until it was in stock and I went, oh, I have to have that. So without further ado, and without wasting your time, let's jump down the table, take a look at what comes in the box. And then as we're going to do with all of these, I'm going to put them together in a later video and let you guys know my thoughts, how it went together, if I had any issues, fitment, or any broken pieces or missing. But for right now, we're just going to take a look at what comes in the box, and I haven't even cracked this open. So let's get to it. All right, here we are. And as you can see, this box is significantly bigger than the other two. This is W-3222. Again, this is the 1/7 scale Monster Hunter Mitsun series female gunner. Regular retail price is $86 plus shipping, of course. So cracking open the box. I love their box. All right, so you get a thick, seems like they probably have more than usual in here. You get a bunch of pictures and I'm sure the parts layout. You get some huge, damn, look at these, some huge water slides, and those are some bright canary yellow. And you get water slides on both sides, two sets of eyes as usual, and they usually double up all the water slides. So technically you only need about half of these. Folding open, you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, that base is so freaking heavy. 13, you get 13 baggies, and wow. I do like, we'll get into it when we do the build on here, but I do like the base because it's multi-layer. It has some splash effects. It is really cool. And technically there's two characters in this kit. There's the girl and then there's the meow. So we're going to shove all that stuff to the side. Again, we already looked at the water slides on here, so I wasn't too sure. You do get your typical four pictures on here, and you can kind of see how it has the water effects. You have the cat thing, and then her, and this is going to be a pretty tall, like pretty tall. I think they rate this at 35 centimeters tall for 1/7 scale. And that's probably at the very top of the bow. So that's going to put it about what, 14 inches, something like that. You actually get two full sheets of all your parts that are included. And taking a look at the first part that makes this up. So you do have your plain base that's down here. Then you have the water effect that's going to end up going on there. There is a little play, but I think that's because there's some pour tabs over here, so it's not sitting down in there all the way. And then you have this grass dirt effect, which is going to go right there. Again, we still have some pour tabs we need to clean off on there just for everything to fit in. And then it looks like some more stuff goes along this edge. But you're looking at about, I want to say, 8 inches across fully on here. In the first baggie, we end up having the cat. And this does not indicate how bad that the mold line is. They just kind of draw along it on things like this so that you can see it. I do like that. But it does seem to, I'm not feeling it. Like, I'm not actually feeling the mold line. They're just showing you where it is. There's a little bit, like, right there. But there's the cat body, or lower half of it anyway. You get her thighs. Next baggie is going to be the clear parts, and you get these, like, bubble splash effects that are coming up out of the wire. Here's a splash effect from, that will go around her foot, I believe, if I remember correctly off of the pictures. So that splash effect will go, if you're looking at the base, I think the splash effect goes right there and then her foot goes onto there. I really like that. It adds a lot of dynamics to it. But you get these bubble effects that are gonna go on there. Really cool on that. Next up, you get some of her hair, and man, this is a lot of hair, but this is a big chunk of her hair. I think that, yeah, this is her hair. So, and you can see there's a lot of keys for more chunks of hair to get attached to this. So taking a look at this, this is a tree that's going to get attached to the base. Next up, you get the umbrella that the cat's going to be holding. Next baggie, we're going to be taking a look at all of this stuff was literally layered together. So you actually have this section, and I believe all of this appears to layer with her body. So you literally have all of these things that layer up. That is a really cool effect. So you actually get 1, 2, 3, you get 4 different layers that just make up her skirt. And then you get this piece that's going to attach to the top of the cat. This is going to be the cat hat. Next baggie, this is going to be her jacket. Next up, this is going to be a skirt that's going to be for the cat, and that's going to fit on just like that. You've got her sleeves. Again, look really well done. Little pour tabs on there. look like more parts of her sleeves. There are so many layers to this kit. I'm not sure what these pieces go to, and some of these are actually cat pieces, so I'm not sure which ones are which. I'm going to assume the smaller ones are probably for the cat. But yeah, so many freaking pieces. Like, it's crazy. So here's the mask for the cat. More little armor pieces. And I've never actually done a Monster Hunter kit before. I've seen them. They look really cute. So here's part of the cat face. What did we do with the mask? So the mask is going to go good, other than there's a wedge on there, so I can't do it, but it's going to slide onto the, it's going to slide onto the cat face right there. So there's the cat head. You've got that piece. You've got her upper body. You've got her waist section and pantsu, or some of her pantsu. This is going to be part of the waist section. Looks like some armor pieces over here. Lots of little armor. You've got her legs. We're gonna have to figure out where a lot of this goes, because I'm not sure and there's no instructions. Her face looks really good. Oh, you thought we were done? Oh no, no, there's still more. Parts for the bow, parts for her hair, more parts. I think these are the parts that I was expecting to go around the edge of the base. Some more armor pieces. These two baggies I'm actually going to leave together. You get some, looks like some lotus flowers and stuff in this baggie. And then in here you get, I don't know, there looks to be like maybe about 10 arrows that are in here for the quiver. And in one of the baggies, there was two more baggies. So you get some sections for the waist. You get some of her hair. I am not seeing any broken pieces or anything in here. You get a couple of bows. And this one, I am not even going to attempt to crack open. Like, look at all those little parts. There's little pieces of rope and her hands and parts for the arrow and bows all over the place. I am not even going to attempt to open this right now. I would bet that there's probably at least 40 pieces in this little bag. And then the last one, which this is going to be the string for the bow. And I'm not going to take this out of the plastic yet, but yeah, so that is probably about, I want to say about 12 inches long, just from end to end. And if I pan out, that is a pile of freaking resin. While you guys are waiting, do you want to make a guess down below on how many pieces total there are? I'll give you a little bit to guess. If you guess 208 pieces, you would be correct. If you guessed anything else other than 208 pieces, you're wrong. That is a lot of freaking pieces for a 1/7 scale kit or PVC figure. Holy hell. And you can see why, as a PVC, these go for a couple hundred dollars, up to 500, sometimes more. You get what you pay for when you get an original PVC. In this case, for the 121 shipped, 97 at a platinum, you're getting what you pay for in parts count. Like, there are a lot of parts. There's a lot of things to hand paint. This can be a lot of fun or a nightmare for someone. If you guys enjoyed this video, you want to see this guy built up, oh God, and primed, and a turnaround, and let you know my thoughts on it and everything, definitely stay tuned. Hit that like button, hit the subscribe button. I will see you guys all in the next video. Stay tuned for my lives on Thursday and Friday. Peace.